see what we have to start off with the piece, and I think this one's good right here. So we'll get things going. Check it out. We're on hardest time. It's at 3 o'clock, but it's really right now. We're supposed to get on. Check it out.
If you want to sign up and share some words, you
have the opportunity to do so. The first name that I see on this list, I hope he's ready to go and share some palabra with us. Let's make some noise for Jacob Rueda.
I just want to say this was really spontaneous. I did not plan this. It just happened, so I figured, what the hell? You know, it's Sunday. I don't really want to be at home, so here I am. Okay. I just wrote this, okay? So, and I call this Taking Back Your Power. And this is something a little based on some of what I write, you know? But I just wrote it right here, so I really hope you guys like it, you know? If you don't, yeah, I'm sorry. Anyway, here we go. Taking Back Your Power. Are you waiting for Jesus to come down? Are you waiting for Obama or Romney to be voted in to the rescue? Are you afraid of the new world order? These and many are all gimmicks to make people, to make you afraid of your own personal power. To defeat control, you must be in control. The banks create money out of the air through fractional reserve banking. The corporations are busy telling people how to live. And the religions tell people what to believe and what and who to pray to. My belief is quite simple. There is no God. There is no devil. No heaven and no hell. There is only you. I'm not done yet. But thank you for the clap. Everyone is busy telling everybody else what to do for them. But the only true power is within you. Remember, you must be in control to defeat control. Run with it and make it your friend. You want a bright new day every day? Be in control of you. Realize your love to help others realize theirs. And stop waiting for the powers from above to save the world. Everything that you need is all within you. No money needed, no president, no government or police needed. All you need is you. And all you are is love. Thank you.
Let's see some noise. This is a little bit of a rough here.
Yeah, I just said that.
Just said that. Yeah, man. I started off talking about love, and you came with the same message, man. It really resonates. And love is not just about romantic love. The way I define it is, our highest expression of our creative human potential. That's a work in operation that I like to really conceive of love, and it takes many different forms. It can be romantic love, but it doesn't have to be exclusively tied to that realm. The way we put passion into our art, that's an expression of love. And we're going to keep it going. I just met this young lady here today, and I was asking her to just clarify her last name for me. So now I can introduce her properly and make some noise for Ray Shaw.
Right. and note the gesture which small flowers make when they open in the morning. You must be able to think back to streets and unknown neighborhoods, to unexpected encounters, and to parties you had long seen coming. Days of childhood, mystery is still unexplained. To parents whom you had to hurt when they brought in a joy and you didn't pick it up. It was a joy meant for somebody else. To childhood illnesses that began so strangely with so many profound and difficult transformations. To days of quiet restrained rooms and to mornings by the sea, to the sea itself. To see to nights of travel that rushed along high overhead and went flying with all the stars. And it is still not enough to be able to think of all that. You must have memories of many nights of love, each one different from all the others. Memories of women screaming in labor and of bright, pale, seasoned girls who have just given birth and are closing again. But you must also have been beside the dying, must have sat beside the dead in the room with the open window and the scattered noises. And it is not yet enough to have memories. You must be able to forget them when they are many. And you must have the immense patience to wait until they return. For the memories themselves are not important. Only when they have changed into our very blood, into glance and gesture, and are nameless, no longer to be distinguished from ourselves, only then can it happen that in some very rare hour, the first word of a poem arises in their midst and goes forth from them.
Cushing's equations. I see a woman with skinny black hair
From behind, you might think she was elderly because she had a staggering walk, like gravity and time are pushing against her. But from the front, you see a very young woman with a mockingly delirious face, a mockingly delirious smile on a pink white face.